Hi, I'm Alison Brie, and I play Sarah in Horse Girl. I did a lot of interviews with my mother about her experiences with my grandmother. The mythology of her and her mental illness really colored my entire childhood. It was a major trauma that influenced my mother's whole life, and the web of that kind of engulfed our whole family. And I'd always wanted to make something artistic about her story, and it turned out to be much more abstract than I think I initially thought that it might be. But when I came back to kind of thinking about why I was so fascinated by it, my personal fear about having mental illness in my bloodline, I keep circling back to it, imagining, is that gonna happen to me? And that is a part of Sarah's journey as well.
I just wish that I could start over.
We don't need to go back or start over. We can start from right here. And, you know, we've had great success here, and we have an incredible team. And I and they are 100% committed to helping you.
Sarah is a bit of a socially isolated woman. She is a horse girl. She grew up riding horses, and she still has a deep love and a deep connection to her horse. Physically, I wanted to make Sarah a little reserved. She's very shy. She has created a world for herself where she doesn't have to interact with other people all that often, but she still gets to do things she loves, like arts and crafts and watching supernatural crime shows and spending time with her horse.
Look what I made you. Is that so pretty?
With other people, she's not a force. She's a little bit meek, so her voice is a little higher than my voice, and she speaks quite softly and timidly. There's like a sort of staccato to the way that she talks and even stands.
I noticed you were a little distracted today.
Here, I'll get that.
Oh.
I just wanted to remind you how important it is to really stay connected to Willow. You know, when you're distracted and looking down and up
yeah.
and around, that's when accidents happen.
I just got a text from my mom, so I'm gonna...
I'll take her tack off. Okay. The costumes are always the best part of any character for me. We were so lucky to have Beth Morgan do the costumes for this movie. She's our costume designer on Glow. And we really wanted the costumes to look and feel real. You know, it's a contemporary movie, but also feel a little timeless. And certainly the way that Sarah dresses, she's a woman who used to have means and doesn't really anymore. So a lot of her clothes are a little bit dated. It's a very specific type of girl that we were trying to portray, and I think Beth nailed it. A lot of the character research was baked into the writing of the film. You know, I was in her head the whole time as we were creating her, so that became very helpful. By the time we were shooting the movie, I knew the character so intimately. We had so many fun actors to play with, and everybody who signed onto the film was so brave. Everyone was so excited and just jumped right in, so it was really fun. All the dialogue in the movie is improvised. Every scene is sort of heavily outlined in terms of what people's objectives are, what they're coming in to say and talk about, but the specific dialogue is not written, and it's important to us, and Jeff feels very strongly about people just feeling real and talking the way that people speak. And a certain type of magic happens when you open that door to let the actors put it in their own words.
Folklore comes from somewhere. So at some point, someone saw a Bigfoot.
Someone saw it, exactly, they saw it. And then they knew that the aliens were using the humans as thermometers and bringing them back up and like downloading all the information to learn about our planet, you know?
Totally.
And they could even be using human clones because that would give them more reliable information, right?
Yeah, that makes sense.
I like to do things that scare me, that are a little intimidating, and just getting to be in the moment. Horse Girl is out on Netflix now. Check it out.